wonder if the chess pieces on the board indicate where I can't go. Perhaps I can find a way to reveal the path. That wasn't too difficult.
Oh, goodness! I do hope you're having as much fun as me. I think I'll keep you around a bit longer.
Revelio.
my inordinately clever friend appear to have traversed this seemingly never-ending dungeon relatively unscathed. And now I suppose you want to go. Everyone leaves me, usually in a straitjacket, never to return. I'm starting to take it personally. I'm tired of having no one to play with.
Ooh.
Ooh. Tell you what, I'll make you a deal. If you can match wits with me now and agree to give me unfettered access to the shop for, say, one day a month to have a little fun, I'll sign a contract. Pursuant to which, let me see, I will blah, 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 blah. Oh, yes, leave you and your customers alone at all other times, etc., etc. You get your shop, I get my chaos. Sound acceptable? Excellent! Let the games begin!
That's just cat's guy. But cat, I mean.
Thank you.
someone deserving of the playground I so meticulously crafted. Such a treat to have fun again in my little dungeon.
I must say, I enjoy a good challenge.
Ah, a kindred, dare I say, spirit.
So, about that contract.
I am a poltergeist of my word.
Just to be clear, what does this agreement entail, specifically?
Pay attention. You guarantee that I can have my fun at least one day each month without fuss. I let you work the rest of the time, mostly, in peace.
Why would you enter into such an agreement?
Much as I love banging about the place, it's no comparison to seeing customers' faces when I bonk them on the heads with a chocolate frog. One doesn't really understand the value of an audience until one is without it.
Very well. I shall agree to your contract, with one small addendum.
Hooray! No more of this unsatisfying banging about all day in a pitiful void! Wait, did you say one small addendum?
I did. In order that I have a successful shop with lots of customers, would you agree to causing chaos only after 9 o'clock in the evening?
Would you agree to at least 2 days a month instead of one?
I would.
Pleasure doing business with you. You've worn me out! Well done. I had a feeling. I have to admit, Cassandra did a wonderful job finding the perfect playmate.
Hello, Penny.
Oh, Penny is so glad you're back.
You knew exactly where I was going when I entered that chest.
Penny was beginning to think yet another shopkeeper was going to end up in St. Mungo's.
Another shopkeeper? St. Mungo's? I think you should explain, Penny. Penny, please stop holding your breath. Tell me what's going on.
Oh, please forgive Penny. Penny is forbidden from telling you anything.
But how can you be forbidden from telling me what's going on? I purchased the shop.
Penny is confused. Penny thought that if you came back, you would own the shop.
You should have told me the truth and punished yourself as necessary. I need to go and find Officer Singer.
Penny is so sorry. Penny wanted to tell you everything. Truly. Surely Officer Singer will know what to do. Penny will wait right here.
Revelio. Officer Singer, I have some information you might be interested in.
Ah, good to see you again. What can I do for you?
Cassandra Mason sold me her shop and then tried to drive me mad in a haunted dungeon.
Cassandra Mason sold you her shop?
I am perfectly capable of owning a shop. But more importantly, did you not hear the bit about the dungeon?
No, I heard that bit too.
And according to the house elf that came with the shop, she's done this sort of thing before, repeatedly.
I wondered what was going on. She seems to have had a great deal of trouble keeping a tenant in that shop. In any event, These are serious accusations indeed. Perhaps a little visit with Cassandra is in order to clear this all up. Shall we?
Hello, Ruth. I see you've met my new tenant.
Cassandra, it's my understanding that you sold your shop and your elf to this student. Now, they've been telling me some very interesting stories about your business practices. Perhaps you should come with me.
Stop her!
Thank you.
find out.
I'm disappointed in you, Cassandra.
Incarcerate! You don't know what you're doing!
Don't I? I always wondered why you couldn't seem to keep a tenant in that shop of yours. I must admit, the notion of a haunted dungeon never crossed my mind. Thanks for this. You can head back to the shop. Check on that house elf of yours, she's probably terrified.
Spoony little traitorous elf! I should have known it was...
Silencio. Oh, and not to worry. Cassandra will immediately file the paperwork needed to grant you ownership of both the shop and the elf. On her way to Azkaban.
Thank you, Officer Singer.
Best of luck to you as the newest shop owner in Hogsmeade.
Penny, I have what I hope will be good news. Officer Singer confirmed that ownership of the shop has now transferred to me.
Oh, well, that is good news. Penny is so relieved. Penny had the most difficult time keeping the truth from you. Penny promises to work as hard as she can for such a kind new owner.
Penny, I found an item of clothing in the dungeon that I'd like to give you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Penny never thought she would be given clothing and become a free elf.
It's my pleasure. You deserve it.
Of course, Penny will be staying on and managing the shop for you.
Penny, you're free. You can do anything you've ever wanted to.
But all Penny has ever wanted to do is run a shop with a friend and sell to the villagers in Hogsmeade.
If that's what you want to do, Penny, then nothing would make me happier. I'm genuinely glad you'll be staying on.
Penny is too. All that's left is for you to choose a sign for your new shop, and Penny will take care of the rest.
I choose stitches and drafts.
Excellent choice. Have a look outside.
Thank you. I shall work on collecting items for the shop's inventory. Oh, and Penny, we'll be closing the shop by 9 o'clock every night.
Have something you'd like Penny to sell for you? Oh, Penny will fetch a good price for what you'd like to sell. wishes you safe and wondrous travels. Oh, perhaps today you have something you'd like Penny to sell for you? Sometimes Penny doesn't understand witches and wizards.
Of all the potions you've brewed.
Thank you. can do this. I can do this. They will want to help.
Is this where we're meeting the Centaurs?
Well, they don't exactly know we're coming, so it's less of a meeting and more of a surprise, I suppose.
Once we tell them about the Snidgets, they'll understand why we came and they'll want to help.
I hope you're right. Perhaps they'll be able to tell that we're sincere. There's something about them that's so knowing. It's almost unnerving.
I suppose they are known for having an air of omniscience.
That's exactly the right word. I just... never mind.
What is it?
It's nothing, truly. We've no secrets to hide.
That's right. We'll simply be honest with them about what we're trying to do. They'll have to help us, won't they?
Yes, of course. You're absolutely right. We'll meet with them, tell them about the Snidgets, and I'm sure to all be fu-
What do you think you're doing here, humans?
Please! We were hoping to speak with you.
Ah! I suppose you'd like a tale for your friends of the time you spoke to a centaur, and it spoke back.
No! Never! We're here because we need your help.
Enough! You made a grave error in judgment in coming here, little witch.
Leave them be, Alec. We do not harm the young. It is not our way.
You forget your place, old fool. I'm the leader of this herd, and while you cling to our way, their kind continue to slaughter beasts like us without a care.
From what I can see, they have slaughtered no one. They will leave here unharmed.
Mark my words, Doran. If I ever see them again, it will be all three of your heads.
Foolish children. Do you know what happens to wizards who wander here? Now, follow me.
Snidgets are still alive, and the poachers are after them. They know that the key to finding them lies in the moonlight, but they don't know what that means, yet. Please, help us find the Snidgets before the poachers do.
Could it be? In the south, there is a cave within which lies what the poachers seek, a moonstone. Retrieve it and place it in the henge in the forest. I, on the other hand, must go speak with the herd. Find me after you have done this.
I don't understand. So the moonlight mentioned in the journal doesn't refer to actual moonlight, but to a moonstone. What do moonstones have to do with Snidgets? And why was he so certain about where we could find one?
Isn't moonstone all around us? Why retrieve one from a cave?
Knowing centaurs, I suspect he's referring to a specific moonstone. We'll likely know it when we see it.
He could have been a bit clearer, or stayed a moment and answered our questions.
Centaurs can be cryptic. Gran says no one talks more in circles than a centaur. It is a shame how quickly he left. What was his name? Doran.
That's what the leader of the herd called him.
Well, if Doran knows something we don't, I'd rather act now and ask questions later. I can head to the library and start looking into the cave he mentioned. I'll let you know what I find.
Revelio. is one of those tables Professor Shah mentioned. Revelio. Revelio. castle. Must have been quite stately in its time. Wasn't so difficult.
Revelio.
This astronomy table will be best used when it's dark. This place has seen better days.
Alohomora.
you do. You may want to. That saved Treadwell. What is this? What just happened to me?
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
do we have here?
Alohomora.
A lost relic from a catacomb which requires a dark sacrifice.
I know how it sounds, but if this can help you, it's worth the risk.
Does Ominous know about this?
He helped find the scriptorium where we discovered Slytherin's spellbook.
Very well. If Ominous will be there, I'll meet you. We don't have much time. Solomon wants to leave Feldcroft.
What? Leave? Never mind. You need to stall him. Buy us time, Anne. Please.
I shall do my best. I'll be in touch.
Solomon can't take Anne from Feldcroft. Where would they go? When would I see her?
Sebastian.
I can't believe my uncle wants to leave Feldcroft. Anne's going to stall him. She must. We need time.
Time? For what?
I've learned more about the relic. I cross-referenced Slytherin's spellbook with everything in the library on relics and dark sacrifices. That's when I realized something. I believe the relic will only work inside the catacomb.
So we have to get Anne to the catacomb and then conduct a sacrifice. Seems risky.
It'll be worth the risk. Our biggest hurdle may be convincing Ominous. Anne will only give this a chance if he's on board.
And we have to keep all of this from your uncle. If he goes to the headmaster, we could be expelled.
Let me handle Ominous this time. As for my uncle, he's not an Auror anymore. What he doesn't know, well, won't hurt us.
Do you think your uncle would tell anyone at the Ministry about all of this if he found out?
If he found out, I doubt he'd go to the Ministry. He didn't part ways with them well, from what I understand. He won't say, but I believe his strong aversion to dark magic has something to do with his time there. Anne thinks he once decided to fight fire with fire, so to speak, and resorted to using an unforgivable curse in a fight against dark wizards. At least that's what she thought she heard. When he realized what his job had led him to become, he left rather abruptly. So, I'm not sure he'd go to the Ministry to report on his own family using dark magic now.
Good luck with Ominous, until we meet again.
I shall let you know when the four of us should meet at the catacomb. Look for my owl. See you soon.
Incendiary.
pleasant surprise.
Rebellion.
Bombarda! Proud.
I'll take them all.
Revelio.
Hello? Over here!
Imperial!
One less follower, Ranrok. Revelio. Looks intriguing. Revelio. It is wonderful to see you back here.
wishes you safe and wondrous travels.
I should investigate.
Bombarda!
Revelio.
Wizards will be defeated.
Blood's on Ranrock's hands.
Revelio.
What are you up to now?
There's no telling what lies in wait for me in there. Revelio! Must be something around here I can climb on. Puzzle.
Revelio. Lumos. One down, two to go. Confringo! Leviosa! Lumos. Revelio. Lumos.
Revelio.
What are they protecting?
Bombarda! Revelio. 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 Could it be the Merlin trial? I know a Merlin trial when I see one. Revelio.
Rebellion.